Hello people, it's Landon here, and I gotta do this video. I have to do it. It's been such a hurdle, and I have to get it done. I have to do the confession. Seriously, it has blown my mind for the past year, and I just have to tell you this to get it done and over with, and here we go. About a year ago, something happened. It's really changed a lot about everything. I can't even explain to you how this past year has completely just blown my mind. So I think the best way to really kind of introduce you guys to what essentially has happened is to explain to you exactly what happened a year ago, and then we'll just slowly catch up, because this video is going to cause more questions than answers. A lot of questions that even I don't know the answer to at this point. Maybe we'll figure it out together. So this is really why I'm doing the video, so let's just get to it. I pretty much left you guys off saying I was doing my big road trip throughout Central and Eastern Canada. We did a little bit of the United States, went to New York. When I came back to Canada, I went to Montreal. And the first time I went through Montreal, I was a little bit culture shocked. It freaked me out that just basically it's a different culture and everybody speaks French. So I drove right through it. I just didn't even experience it at all. It just kind of freaked me out and I wanted to get to the Maritimes right away. When I went to the Maritimes though, a local there told me, oh, they speak English just fine. Just speak English and they'll speak English. So now I'm excited to go to this big city and, you know, meet people there. I go to Montreal and I use a social media app, of course, to meet people. The strange thing is, all throughout Canada, even in the US, this app worked great. And then I go to Montreal and lots of people willing to chat with me, but nobody wanted to meet me. And it's this like big city that I want to like explore, and everybody's willing to chat with me, nobody's wanting to meet me, and I'm getting legitimately angry. I'm getting really pissed off. It got to a point where I was like, screw this, deleted the app, got into my vehicle, went to basically en route to Ottawa. I then reinstalled the app, but because I was still angry and sort of as like a see what would happen kind of thing, in the profile description, I basically vented my anger. And I said, you know what, I just want to meet a buddy that I can just beat the living hell out of, just put on some boxing gloves and beat the shit out of each other. Totally thinking, you know, it's just me venting. Probably the app will block me because, you know, hate crime, really. And to my surprise, granted, 99% of the people on this app did not respond. And I didn't, I said to myself when I did this, I'm not going to say anything to anyone, but I just want to see if it gets a rise out of anyone. And 99% of people did not respond, but the 1% that did, holy hell, we're talking like hockey players, construction workers, the kind of guys that Landon likes. Oh, here they are. Like, it was just like, holy smokes. And so these guys are messaging me and they're like, hell yeah, I got boxing gloves in my basement. Let's glove up and beat the crap out of each other and whatever. And I'm like, holy hell. And I'm loving it. It's just amazing. And I'm super riled up from these conversations. And I get to Ottawa, I think there was like three guys that were like, hell yeah, we gotta do this, but we didn't have like a facility or like a space to really do it at. One guy suggested that we do it in like some like field somewhere, which at the time, and I'm doing perhaps a little bit of foreshadowing, but at the time I was like, no, I'm not into that because like this is brand new. I've never like trash talked to someone on a social media app. This is really weird. But was super riled up, was like, oh my gosh, if I actually meet someone to like fight them, I need to get some boxing gloves. So I literally went to Walmart in Ottawa and bought 2 pairs of boxing gloves. I calmed down by the end of the evening and didn't meet those guys. But then some guy messaged me on the app and said, "Hey, I like your shirt. I'm going out swimming in at my apartment. Do you want to come?" And I'm like, "Oh, awesome. Yeah, like I'd love to make a friend in Ottawa. Why not?" So I'm a little bit more sane now. And I'm like, "Yeah, I'll go meet this guy." And he's just like super buff and muscular. And it's like, wow, like these are the kind of guys that I like. Meet him at his apartment. We go swimming. We have like a meal. I think we ended up watching Bob's Burgers at his place or whatever. It was really awesome. And at the end of the day, you know, I sleep in my Jeep, so I'm like, okay, I got to find a place to, you know, park and spend the night or whatever. And the guy's like, "Oh yeah, like it was really awesome hanging out with you. Here's my number. We should hang out tomorrow." I'm like, "Oh yeah, I'm going to be in Ottawa for the next day or two." I go in my Jeep, go find a place to park for the night. And just as a sort of thank you, I sent him a text and I said, "Hey, it was really great meeting you. I want to hang out with you tomorrow." And he replies saying, "You know, it was really great hanging out with you, but I kind of wish you would have done something." And I was like thinking, like, "What do you mean?" And he's like, "Well, not gonna lie, the whole entire time that you were watching Bob's Burgers with me, I kind of wanted to beat the living shit out of you." And I was like, "Holy hell yeah, like I'm gonna beat the living hell out of you." And it really escalated to the point where he wanted me to go back at 1:30 in the morning, and I'm like, no, I should really go to bed, but dude, we really gotta meet tomorrow. The next day, this is where things get crazy. So I just remember that we hung out for the day. I can't remember who started it. Like, one of us grabbed each other. We're like, "I'm gonna beat the crap out of you." And he's like grabbing me and I'm grabbing him and whatever, and we're like wrestling around and like throw him on like the bed or whatever. And I remember I had him pinned down. I said, "I got boxing gloves in my Jeep. You want me to go get them?" And he literally went, "Hell yeah, go get them." So I go downstairs to go get the boxing gloves out of my Jeep, get them out of my vehicle, and I start coming back up to his apartment. And now this is the moment where I'm like, what am I doing? What is happening? I don't know if he's like a professional boxer. I've never done this before. Like, what the heck is going on? And so I was really kind of like riled up, but terrified at the same time. I go into his apartment. I hand him like, you know, the container of boxing gloves, and I have a pair of myself. And I just remember like staring each other down, opening up the package, never been used ever before. And just thinking to myself like, oh my gosh, like he's 200 pounds, muscular. I could get the living crap beaten out of me, but I didn't want to reveal my fear, right? So we go into his room, we stand on his bed, and we take off our shirts or whatever, and we put on the boxing gloves. And this is the moment where I'm like, okay, it's either do or die. So I said to him, "Hit me. Freaking hit me. Because I need to know how hard we're going to go, whether or not I'm going to like it, what's happening." But I'm super, super riled up. And so he throws a punch, and on a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being a knockout punch, it was like a 2. Maybe like even like a 1. It was like really light. So I told him, I'm like, "Is that how you freaking hit? Hit me like a man." And he like throws a punch right at me, and now we're just slugging it out, right? And like no technique, no mouth guard, nothing. And it kind of, right away, number one, I couldn't believe how sweaty we were getting. Like, it's a crazy workout. We're just like slugging each other. But number two, I'm 117 pounds. He's around 200. I'm kind of kicking his ass. Because as it turns out, like, he's throwing punches at me and I'm just staring at him. Like, I'm not even like blinking, right? Like, I'm just like, I'm actually kind of enjoying it. And I'm like throwing punches and he's flinching and he's looking away and I'm like slamming into him, kind of beating the crap out of him. And eventually he like clinches onto me and he throws me on the bed. And at that point, I'm like, holy smokes, this is so awesome. Like, dude, you're so great. Literally, that just happened. The crazy thing is, that was a year ago. I haven't changed my social media profile. So I'm going to let you guys process that. You're going to have tons of questions about it, probably. But as it turns out, there's an actual thing called agonophilia. It's basically arousal of fighting. It's an actual thing. So turns out I'm an agonophiliac and had to get that out there because it has really consumed my life this past year. Anyway, I'll keep you guys up to date. It was good to finally get that out in the open, and we'll talk to you later. Take care. Bye.